my name is Taylor Alexander, and I am a second-year graduate student in the Communication Disorders Program at Eastern Kentucky University, and I am so close to graduating with my Master of Arts in Communication Disorders. I was born and raised in Elizabethtown, Kentucky, and started college at Northern Kentucky University, where I spent about a year and a half without knowing what I wanted to do or who I wanted to be. And then my parents were finally like, "Okay, Taylor, you need to make a decision on what you want to do." And I was like, "But I don't know. I knew that I loved the educational field. I knew that I loved the medical field. And I just couldn't make a decision between the two." So I met with some elementary education teachers, and they suggested that I look into speech pathology. And so I did two observations. I did one observation of a speech path in a school setting, and then I did one of a speech path in an outpatient medical setting. And after those two observations, I was absolutely sold. I knew that this is what I wanted to do. I had never really thought of communication outside of like public speaking or, you know, giving a presentation during class. But after recognizing that communication is something that we all do, we all have a right to, and something that we really all deserve, I decided that this is where I wanted to dedicate my life and my career. So I applied to programs across the state, had the opportunity to tour Eastern, to look at their clinic, to meet some of the faculty and staff, and I just fell in love with that campus and the program. And so I started my undergrad career in 2014 at Eastern, and then graduated in 2016 with my Bachelor's of Science in Communication Disorders. And at the same time that I was applying for grad school, I also had the opportunity to apply for a position within an organization that I had really done a lot of work and leadership with during college. And so applying for this position, I was just kind of thinking, you know, it'll be good application experience, you know, even if I don't get it, you know, it'll be good experience. So I got a call for an interview, and then I got offered the position. And so I was kind of at this crossroad, and I'm like, do I take this position or do I go to grad school? And of course, my parents are like, you need to go to grad school. And I'm like, I will. I know that I will go back to grad school because I love this field so much. But I really also knew that this other position was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and it was something that my heart was telling me to do. So I took the position as an educational leadership consultant, did that for a year, loved every second of it, and learned so many things that I had not yet had the opportunity to learn in the classroom. And so really just kind of learning about working with other people and collaborating and just how to carry myself as a professional all served as great learning experiences to kind of carry with me into grad school. So by the end of that year of that position, I was like, okay, I'm ready to go back to grad school. And so I started at Eastern in 2017, and I'm now getting ready to graduate with my Master of Arts in Communication Disorders. And it really is kind of surreal to be kind of nearing the end of that educational experience and starting my professional experience as a speech pathologist. So when I was thinking about kind of my interests in this position and why I had submitted my application, it really kind of came down to two main points. Both kind of stemming from experiences and things that I've learned this past semester in the school setting. So the first one being that I have a desire to build really strong, and not only strong, but really positive relationships with the students and the faculty within the school setting. I think that ensuring that you have those relationships established and really built very strongly with the staff helps to really create the foundational steps for student success. Because, you know, a student may see a variety of professionals throughout the day, and making sure that that communication is there between the professionals really kind of ensures that the student's strengths and weaknesses and potentials are really being reached and established. The second one being that I have a very strong desire, and it is my hope as a speech-language pathologist to really help students identify and really use their strengths in an effort to improve their weaknesses. So you guys, your vision really does a great job of wording it as excavating their gifts. So So helping them identify their gifts and use those gifts and, you know, their strengths in communication to help really work toward strengthening their weaknesses or their areas of need or their targets for communication, what we would be working on. So I really like how you guys word it in excavating the gifts and really identifying those gifts and using them to help the students throughout their educational career really build their foundational skills to set them up for success, not only through their school years, but in their school years and beyond. So I'm really excited about this opportunity, and it's really great to meet you all and finally put faces to the names. And I thank you for your time.